Hi, everyone. I've been requested by a subscriber and slash work colleague about redoing and re-recording the Life is Strange from episode 1 to tie in with my new tower to give the game justice, as they said that the video of my bonus episode showed a lot better gameplay and that from it did with when I had my old system for my laptop. So I'll be redoing the episode, I'll re-upload, and I will either keep the other ones, the first videos I've done, or I'll remove them once, put these on, and so they're all continuing with better video quality. But yeah, so I'll choose as much of the same answers, same choices as before. But when I get to the last episode, I'm keeping everything same, and there won't be no change to anything I do on that. Or Brave New World, Hal is empty. Them ones, like, I will try and go for the same lines as I did in the original episodes. Like them, I'm not gonna do any commentary apart from in a few spots here and there, because I just want everyone to enjoy the video, enjoy how it looks, enjoy what's happening, and most importantly, enjoy the music, which I will try and find out each of the songs that plays in certain parts, and I'll put them in the description for people to find and listen to if they want to. So without further ado, let's relive Life is Strange before the storm.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes! Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here. No trespassing? No way. Holy shit. This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door. If I owed somebody $1,000, I'd be shitting my pants. Those guys need to get a room. Or not. Damn.
Mind your own business.
I know these can't fight.
Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here. Now, what to draw? Hey, kids! Free candy. I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends. Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid, but you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Is that your bike over there?
Yep.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside. Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Aww, isn't it past yours?
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Look at my face. Do I look cute? Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Maybe I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
A girl like you, with pretty, pretty flowers on her bicycle, shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan... Look, my boss decides who gets in, all right?
Bosses suck. Screw the man and fuck the rules, dude.
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on.
This is intense! Shit!
Hey, Delia! Come!
Cute dog. Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrap.
What's her name?
Delia. She doesn't usually like people.
Yeah. Me neither. Sober up, girl. You're missing the show. That shirt is rad. Are you selling
20
any-
20 bucks.
What?
20 bucks for a t-shirt.
That's really expensive. Dick. Sweet knife. Just like the one my mom refused to get me for my birthday. Looks like that parking brake is the only thing keeping that car from rolling down the ramp.
Hey, I told you 20 bucks. You looking to get beat?
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative. Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
Shit! No, 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 no! Come on!
Thanks for playing, dick. Oh, yeah! Sweet, sweet victory. That's like 200 bucks. Not worth it. These guys might burn me at the stake. Nothing sadder than a neglected bong. Feel less. Yes, please. What are you looking at? $300 dock workers laid off, their pensions canceled? God, Prescott's a real tool. That's totally me in 5 beers. Okay, 3. How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room?
Bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup, studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
God, the internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
So, you come here a lot, or...?
Yeah.
Right. It's cool.
I'm really glad you approve.
I'll see you later.
Whatever.
No thanks. I try to avoid hepatitis when I can. Classy. Here we go.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Yep. My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Nope. Don't care, either.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine. Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
She returns.
Did you see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon Merrick?
I see you've heard of him. This is his place. Damon's a friend of mine.
Where do those stairs go?
Up.
Real helpful, Frank. I mean, will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know? Floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine. I'll see you later.
Whatever.
Yeah, in this next bit, when I have a choice, I'm going to choose differently to see what actually happens with this bit. But I'll let this...
Yes! Finally made it!
Play out
I can't
for
believe
a small
it!
Bit, so you can... sort of a couple of things out on... Yeah, but it's like I'll think of me in the meantime, so.
You spilled my beer, bitch!
You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
Hey, I'm sorry about the beer, okay?
Not good enough. We're not done.
Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's calling us out, dude. She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Rachel? Come on! Hurry up!
Let me go, Frank!
Not gonna happen! Calm down!
Come on, man!
Walk away!
Screw this! Bullshit.
Get the fuck out of here!
Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell. Daily rituals are important, even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you. Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day?
Rolling. Wakey-wakey, edgy-bakey.
Last night, seeing Firewalk live. Those skeevy assholes. That girl. Was that really Rachel Amber? You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes. That really was Rachel Amber. And she saved my life. How was last night even real? Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear. I bet long Max Silver traded her hat for beer and booty long ago. I really should get going. Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong, and it was awesome. No more unicorns, no more princesses, and no more fucking rainbows. Words of wisdom, don't fail me now. Just ask Steve Jobs. Shit, where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone. With Mom's. Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. Ah, Mom! Bad enough that David comes here for dinner. How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating? Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. I hate that she hides all her old pictures of Dad. What's the matter, Mom? You don't want Dad to see your new boyfriend? You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this. All right, phone. Donde estás? There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Chloe, breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room. Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair is his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray. The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, scourge of Arcadia Bay.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone too? No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry. Coming, Mom.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out. Pot roast? Mom hates pot roast. It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food. Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
I thought you hated pot roast.
You can have a no thank you helping.
No, you hate pot roast. I don't care.
I don't hate it. And David likes it. And don't say you don't care.
So that's what we're doing now? Whatever your boyfriend likes? Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole.
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah, I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Firewalk? Is that the band you mentioned last week?
I'm still bummed you wouldn't let me go.
Mm-hmm.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that—
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Ever again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David should start paying rent.
He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not? Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too. Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do. Little dude's like, what the hell just happened? Here they are. Let's get these to David so he can drive away. No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I better get going. Family pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember which one. Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max? And never looked back? Any letter from Blackwell is never good. Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Any letter from Blackwell is never good. Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year.
Come on, sweetheart. I'm sure David's waiting for his keys.
What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Why do you women always always take forever to get ready.
We're hoping you men will leave without us. No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something? Do these have chapters on hotwiring your mom's boyfriend's car so you can drive it off a cliff? Asking for a friend. Fifty-fifty chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10. If it's in my garage, it gets my special treatment. What message does David really need to hear? Got it. This was the photo Mom took down from the living room. Guess we don't have room for it and David's mustache. Uh-oh. Mom's been cleaning again. Dad's old camera. Do they even make film for these anymore? Damn. The stereo used to be in Dad's workshop. I should hook it up in my room before garbage day gets it first. Tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you. See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of carbon
deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
Fine, whatever. Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Respect him? I think it's time I show this asshole I'm not interested in anything he has to say. What's clear is fuck you.
Language. You are way out of line, young lady.
Language? Here, let me put that in a language you'll understand. Foxtrot, uniform.
You've got a smart mouth, don't you?
Let me dumb it down for you. I mean, sorry. What has fewer syllables than dumb?
Hey, watch your... I can crap bigger than you, got it?
Oh, that's what I smell. A giant load of crap.
You... Your mother... You're breaking her heart.
At least she has a heart. All you have is... What's it called when you've got one porn stash and zero game?
I was in the army. You will respect me.
You're not my father. You're not even on the same planet as my father.
My job is to make sure you and your mother have a safe and peaceful home.
Do I come to your place of employment and... Oh, that's right. You don't have one.
If you were a man,
I... It's cool. If you were a man, I wouldn't go so easy on you, either.
Don't know why I bother trying.
Mission accomplished. Country music? Dad loved this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old friend. You're in the midnight again. What a beautiful day.
Yeah, punks. We've done this dream sequence and we have pulled up at a Blackwell. I will end the episode there and we'll continue next time and we'll play the Dungeons Dragons game game with the two, I forgot the names now. So we'll come back once this is done.
I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad. This isn't right. If Mom were here, she'd tell him to turn that junk off.
Dad, turn it up.
Picking up my lover from the grocery store.
Okay, so we are, so as I said at the beginning of the dream sequence, we shall end the video here. I have changed a couple of the scenes in this one, just to see how they change in the next, in the recurring events. But I kept good job to how they were before. So we'll come back to this next time, carry on the story, and relive the memories. So subscribe. Yeah, subscribe. I've got a donation goal set up that I'll have in the description. £40 to £60 for a better studio mic. And in between my uploading, which I'm hoping to try and achieve it at least 2 to 3 times a week, I shall put into the description of some streamers that I watch who are good. So you can always watch them. Yeah, them. And subscribe to them, or them, show them support. And yeah, support. And also, so probably just like if you catch them on a live stream, just probably let them know that Mob sent you. They'll know who you mean, and I'll be fine with you. But please respect their rules like you would any person. So, okay. So until next time, have fun. Stay weird.